All right, here's what you missed, starting with Kendall Milton and his 23 career rushing touchdowns for Georgia.
In Georgia, they share the rock in the run game. It's a crowded backfield.
Kalen Robinson of Texas.
He's an excellent returner. Got four return touchdowns. Get a lot of opportunities on offense, but there's the speed you see in the return game.
4-4-2. Cody Schrader of Missouri.
He's one of the best stories in the draft. Walk-on coming from Truman State. Led the SEC in rushing.
All right, Monmouth is in the house, man. Monmouth in the house.
Jeez. Monmouth is rolling.
Sure did. Oh, 4-4-6.
Nice.
Write that one down, huh?
Yeah, absolutely. That was a little bit of a question, too, to see what that top speed was going to look like, and he answered that emphatically.
How much Monmouth film have you grinded in the last
grinded
few
some,
weeks?
I've grinded some Monmouth film. He's a short stepper. He's likes to bounce it a little bit, and here we go with we got the Purdue coming up. We've
Purdue
got some
contingent.
Fans here.
Oh, yeah, they're feeling it in basketball, too, right about now.
That big guy's been there for like 10 years.
By the way, I said that about Ronnie Cicely back in the 80s.
Nice.
In Syracuse.
Number four, I want to say, for the Cuse.
Tyrone Tracy Jr. Trying to boil her up here for the home fans at the 2024 Scouting Combine.
A little stumble there. Keep going. It's a good time. He can go faster than that.
Heck of a stumble.
Heck yeah. Take that.
Jamie?
Rich, 2 years ago, Tyrone Tracy Jr. was a sub-200 wide receiver special teamer at Iowa. He actually let a thought creep into his mind that football might not be for me in the long term, but he made a change. Transferred to Purdue, put on 15 pounds, and put that RB on the front of his chest. He said, watching guys like Jahmyr Gibbs succeed at 210 in the NFL and with the creativity of the offenses in the league have allowed him to have hope for what he can do at the next level. And that family contingency he has, he is an Indianapolis native, so you know they're representing here today.
Oh, boy, no doubt. Kimani Riddell of Troy.
I said he was a mini Josh Jacobs with his running style.
All right, as I was hoping, Pat's in the house. And that's the fans getting the reaction. There you go, Pat.
There he is.
He is a big fan favorite here. There you go. We're going to get Pat's coming to the booth.
Oh, that'll be fun.
May or may not have known about his credentialing for today. Michael Wiley of Arizona.
Take your time. I'm cool with it, man. You did the right thing.
He's got interesting running style. He'll run a little high, and then he'll drop a level and unload and run through contact.
Who was doing the running earlier this week when we saw Monty Austin for it?
That was Alabama's Dallas Turner.
That's right.
He ripped off a 4-4, and Monty got excited. Like, he thought he blamed me. I said, I'm not in charge of that. You got caught. That's on you.
Oh, man. We don't want people to start having poker faces around here, you know?
Well, when you see defensive linemen running the 4-4s, you're not going to be able to contain yourself.
I know. That's a reaction. Wiley with a 4-5-6. Nicely done. Charles.
Hey, guys. And Deej, I just want to start in with these smaller school running backs because they're starting to emerge. We talked yesterday about how school kids are coming from smaller schools playing up and playing well. Well, in this one, Jaden Sheridan from Monmouth. Kimani Riddell, who we just saw, and we saw him at the Senior Bowl. These guys can flat out compete. Riddell was fantastic playing for Troy. And last thing, let's just go ahead and get out of the way. The great nephew of the great Hank Aaron. So when he hits a big long run, that's your home run hitter right there.
Nicely done. And nice job, CD, jumping in because your Vol's getting ready to run. I'm going to lay out because I think he's got a chance to be the fastest one. Yeah. I just want to see what this looks like.
I'm going to get out of the way here for Peter because he's been talking about him for a while. I'm going to let him keep talking about it.
Let's see him run first.
Here's Jalen Wright of Tennessee. Start again. It's all right.
Rich, he just did a broad jump right before here. It's the long jump. Goes 11-2. It's the second longest ever recorded at the combine by a running back. The longest, Justin Fargus in 2003.
Oh, yeah. Huggy Bear.
That's right.
Yes, sir. And now he's going to be running the 40. This guy is an athletic freak show. Let's see.
By the way, Justin Fargus married a Vol, Nikki Caldwell, the great basketball player at Tennessee. Married to Justin Fargus, and the Vols are getting in it all the way through.
I mean, that's emptying the vault.
Yeah,
there you go.
All right. Treasure trove of information.
Tell us where they're registered.
Already done.
Good. All right, let's see what we can do here with Jalen Wright.
He's going to fly. He is so springy. That was the first note I wrote when I watched him. He just explodes.
He's out. Four.
I think he can get a better start because he started really rolling once he got out. You look at the numbers going back to Tennessee.
Okay.
Kamara caught the ball a little bit more, but just in terms of a dynamic, explosive guys, you see the verticals there, the similarity. Jalen running a tick faster there, but the Vols put out some running backs over the years. Jamal Lewis wasn't too bad.
2K runner and obviously Alvin Kamara. So here's our second go-round of the 40s from the running back group. See who's going to better their time, rest on their times.
One of the names, CD, when you see the time there, the 4.67, you go, oh, man, that's troublesome. Kyren Williams, what he did in the league last year for the Rams, ran a 4.65 here.
Kyren Williams was a fantasy football waiver wire darling. He was dominant. And Mooney Bailey with a 4.67 in the first run.
And there we go.
There you go.
Significantly.
Stacy.
DJ, you mentioned Cody Schrader and the journey that he's had, and I spoke to him this week, the running back out of Missouri. He said he's been overlooked his whole life. Obviously, he's from St. Louis, Missouri, and he walked on after a stop at Truman State. But what's interesting about it is back in high school, he was basically told Missouri came to watch him play. They walked in the building. And then they walked out of the building after they saw him. And so walking on, it was just a personal mission, guys, to prove them wrong and represent the school he'd always wanted to go to.
With Jim Harbaugh watching, Blake Corum running. And he'll stick with his first time. The Harbaughs in their
they approve.
Rose Bowl gear here at the Combine. There's your comp with Devontae Freeman. A terrific career in the league. So the running backs are running. And when we come back, we'll show you what you have missed.